seasonal employees. Seasonal employees are employing for 3 months, 4 months, then they to employ again, depending on the requirement of the business. Now we're saying that though with the new supplement act number 47, this will pose a challenge because considering a shorter period for employment on a fixed term contract is now 12 months. So we don't have that room again to employ people for 6 or 4 months like we had before, who were seasonal employees for the purpose of fixed term contract. You see, so for the issue of seasonal employees to be afforded annual leave, it's a challenge now because you can no longer employ a person below 12 months period of time.
Sorry. Yes. If I understand you correctly,
yes.
If we do consider this cycle to be the 12 months, which starts immediately after the employment,
sure.
This means you'll have each individual have a different leave cycle, right?
Yes, of course.
So if I joined, if my organization's fiscal year starts in January to December, I joined in July.
Yes.
I can prolate my leave to April the next year because my leave cycle has not ended.
Definitely.
It does not end with the fiscal year of the organization.
No. Leave cycle, of course it's your leave. The so-called, what you're saying, the so-called organizational year of
fiscal year.
It's all about the business of the company. You know, a company is a legal entity. Doesn't relate with your annual leave. So, their financial year is all about projection of the tax and so on and so on, but it doesn't relate with your leave. Leave cycle remain to be your leave cycle, and every person has got his own leave cycle. That's why human resource managers are advised to keep leave roster, so to track records of the leave for each and every employee. And you don't need this money.
Yeah.
Yes. So, continue with the annual leave, the provisional section 31, subsection 7, forbid leave encashment, has been amended by the new legislation. This is what I was trying to. The Employment and Labor Relations Law of Business Amendment of 2015 has deleted subsection 7 of the Mother Act, which is Act number 6. By substituting that subject to subsection 6, an employer shall pay the employee 1 month salary in lieu of annual leave to which that employee is entitled or was called upon to work. My friend, you say that in Kenya, this is not the best practice. It is not allowed.
Yes, the law does not express.
Does not express, yes.
Yet.
The same
law says an employee must take.
Yes. Even here, the requirement to go leave is mandatory. But in some circumstances, it may happen that the nature of the business compels that person to keep providing his service for the employer. So if there are these compelling requirements, we can sell, and it is allowed to sell your annual leave. But it should be under very special circumstances. Because us and you, we have many things in common. Many things in common in terms of legal. And so it was like you also. But later they come to see that there are people who are compelled to be on duty and they cannot be paid only because the law does not give them room to be paid. So that's why they need to, because as I said before, right to remuneration is part and parcel of the standards of work. So if this person has give out his service, why should we not?
Does it say anything about taxation
for that? It should be taxed. It is not in the Employment and Labor Relations Act, but it is in the Income Tax Act, Section 7 of the Income Tax Act. It talks about the income from employment. Then it tells exactly what should be tax from the employee.
Imagine that it's taxes, everything, all the way through.
So, and the pay can also be prorated. For example, if I took half of my leave, so I can be paid half the month, the salary. So if I took 14 days, and I did not take the other 14, and so that I can be paid the 14 days, right?
Yes, of course. But why would you take 14 and...
For the same reasons that, for example, some of us, our roles, it's not possible, almost impossible to be away for a month.
Sure. Yeah. Exactly. That's why. No, any question from the, on the part of annual leave?
So on the leave cycle, is it supposed to be the cycle from the first day of appointment, another year, or it can be just the 12-month cycle?
No, it starts with your contract date of commencement of your contract date. So, if your contract commences on the 1st of April, then the new cycle starts from the 1st of April up to the length of 12 months.
So, I have a question. Okay, so for untaken leave, for untaken leave, at the end of the leave cycle, as an employer, am I supposed to, and am I obligated to pay this leave, or it can be carried over, and someone can take it later in another cycle? And if yes, how long can this be carried over?
Okay. The law says that in the circumstance of the compelling requirement, which forbid this person to go on leave, the maximum duration this leave can be carried out in 6 months for the following leave cycle. But you should put a note that this the taken leave will only be carried for. That's why you have something is called accrued leave. When you terminate a person and you pay for her temporary benefits, you have a category is called accrued leave. This is accrued leave, a leave which arose on the circumstances like this. This person can go on leave not later than 6 months on the following leave cycle. So after the 6 months have expired on the following leave cycle, this will be treated as accrued leave. And this person can no longer go because he has a new leave cycle to utilize. So he'll have the accrued leave, which will be now be paid if he's getting terminated later.
So you don't have to pay while he's still employed, you only have to pay once he's terminated.
No. You can pay while he's still employed, but
if he leaves,
yes, you can pay while he's still in the course of employment. You can write a letter, and because it is just right now that he failed to go for leave because of our own business requirement, so obviously we pay. But if he failed to go on leave because of his own, this is not just acceptable and cannot be paid. But let's say there are people who have not gone for leave for 5 years, and every year is a new leave cycle. So what I'm saying is, those accrued number of years, when person accrued all this time and he was not going to leave, is to terminate, to pay them as pay them as accrued leave. And it is not best practice to remain with the person inside the company. You have not paid leave for 5 years and he's still working. I mean, you're waiting to pay him. I'm not talking payments in terms of temporary benefits. I mean, I'm talking payments in the normal course of employment. Then you're paying the payroll a person accrued leave for five years. Where were you to pay every year? Let's say, in terms of audit, this is a query. For the purpose of audit, this is a query.
Sorry, can this section apply also to the casual as well? Those who have the contract is for instance, if you have a casual for 10 years.
Casuals are not part of I'm not part of Anyo. Because Anyo, as it is, the way Anyo means 12 months. The casual can work for 2 weeks, and you'll find him again after 4 weeks. Again, he cannot be available. So they have that cause of status which doesn't qualify them to be. And in many companies, you find there are two set of payroll for casuals and for employees. You see? So when you distinguish that itself, it will not amount them automatically to put them in a different modality of which they can no longer be afforded annual leave.
So for instance, if I have the casual and for 10 years and still in casual, so if he wants to encash the leave, by law, is it allowed?
No, it's not allowed. And you know also, when you employ a casual, it depends with the kind of the task you give this person to do. Because you cannot, let's say, you cannot employ, first of all, a casual should do those tasks which are not professional. This we are together. And you cannot employ a casual for task which in the same course which this person is doing, there are other people also who are employees and who are doing. So normally casuals in their status, let's say if we call them Mwabebazege, Mlinga Gorofa,